strange fruit hanging from the papa tree.
So you'll notice the middle is missing, but when the mango is like this, I already kind of ate the middle. You, from the top, take a knife and you cut along the seed on both sides. So the big seed in the middle, it's gone already, it's in the trash. And then I go ahead and suck off the seed because there's a lot of mango left over. And then you really got the big bulk of it, right? So then I slice, and I diagonal slice. Same thing. And then now with a spoon, you can go ahead, I need two hands anyways, you can kind of carve out, scoop under, and all it leaves is the skin. Other than that, I'm getting ready to read this 12 rules, Jordan B. Peterson. I've read the first couple pages so far. My man Jordan, actually, another Jordan, gave it to me last night. So we follow that up with like drawing. And so this is just a part of my morning ritual. So this is actually, I do this at night. It helps me debunk, helps me calm down from the day. And if you'll notice, that's a little bit of what I actually drew. There's the TV. Let's see how good are we. It's a new hobby, so don't judge me, but I wouldn't care anyways. But you'll notice that's a little bit of that right there. I gotta draw the boxing gloves. I think I drew books instead. This mango is amazing. So one of the techniques, I found to know when a mango is ripe, it's not sour, is when you smell the butt. I don't have the mango anymore, but when you smell the butt, where the hole is, it should smell sweet. You can tell when it smells sour, and you can also tell by a little bit of the firmness, the texture. So let me eat this mango. I'm gonna read a little bit more of my book, and then I gotta go after my client call. I got a client call coming up at 7:30. It's like 2 minutes from now. 7:30 p.m. in the U.S. I'm here in Bali, and for now, I'm gonna enjoy this mango.
Hey, what's going on? It's Pernell Bobby checking in, and I want to tell you a little bit about how my coaching call just went. One of my guys, he's actually getting ready to make a very big leap. I won't go ahead and spill his business, but I want to take the principle out of this, right? And the principle was, man, now that he's been receiving coaching and mentorship and things of that nature, well, what am I going to do, right? Like, now I thought I wanted to do this, this, and this, but now I know for a fact that there's so much more for me out there. There's so much more that I want to do with my life. And now I have this unknown and unfamiliar space. I got this space. And it becomes daunting, especially if you don't have any insight, right? And I was able to explain to him through my own experience that that space, that unknown, is the best place to create from. He was feeling in one way demotivated because it's like, man, I thought I wanted to do this, and now I realize like that I don't want to be a slave to my passion, and I actually want to do, I don't know yet. But because I don't know, because I don't have this clarity on where I want to go, it's demotivating, it's daunting. I was like, okay, that's one perspective. The other perspective that you can have upon this is that like the best place to create from is the unknown. Because if what you're going to do tomorrow and the day after that and a month from there and 3 years from there and then 15 years later is always going to be the same, and you know it because it's that familiar to you, there's really not that much space to create something brand new, is there? There's really only space to continue to be a slave to your own passion, to be a slave to your own mind. And so what am I saying right now? What I'm saying is that coaching call, number one thing that we were able to take away from it is the best place to create something new is from a space of being in the unknown, right? Because when we're in a familiar cycle, that could be very beneficial when it comes to rituals and routines and things like that. But even those need to grow, because the one thing that is inevitable among death is change. And even that is a change, because you went from living to dying. So take that with you and let's get back tapped into my morning ritual routine. And just so you can see a little bit about how I'm living my life and how you may be able to implement some new things that create some open space, some things that are not necessarily familiar to you to utilize as a tool in your life. So stay tuned. I'm excited to see where you go in your life. And I want you to just reach out, you know, leave a comment, leave a message, book a call with me, get on the phone 20 minutes with me. It's free, it costs you nothing. And you know, it may be the call that just changed your life.
Okay, I cannot tell you that I know what this is because I really, really don't, but I'm trusting it. When I read it, and it really is delicious. I can tell you that. I'm gonna go ahead and use that banana. This is from the bakery. I cannot tell you that this is good for you. This is not good for you, but I'm gonna do it. All right, chop that bad boy up. I know that little black gunk don't look like it's like, oh my God, but it's amazing.
I just need to clear my mind now. It's been racing since the summertime.
Freeze.
Now I'm holding down the summer now.
Freeze.
And all I want is what I can't buy now. Cause I ain't got the money on me right now. And I told you to wait.
Freeze.
Yeah, I told you to wait.
Freeze.
So I'ma need a little more time now. Cause I ain't got the money on me right now. And I thought you could wait.
Freeze.
Yeah, I thought you could wait. These bitches surrounding me.
Bodies.
Oh,
I
want something now, man.
Then
they talk about me. Would be lost without me. We could have been somebody. Thought you'd be different about it. Now I know you're not it. So let's get on with it. We could have been somebody. Said you had to tell somebody. Let's take it back to the first party. When you tried your first Molly, it came out of your body. It came out of your body. Running naked down the lobby. And you were screaming that you loved me. Before the limelight tore you.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. I didn't do the meditation because that's the time where on my morning rituals, my phone is off for the first hour, it's off for the last hour. A lot of times it's longer than that because I don't really know how long my meditation is, but I've been feeling that it's been longer and longer because I've been getting more and more in touch. And beyond that, you saw some of the emotional freedom tapping, that EFT. I'm tapping different parts of my body, whether it's the face, the top of my crown, my kidneys, and it just prepares your body for the battle of the day, right? Allows you to seize that day and help you feel alive, because how you move is how you feel. Joe Dispenza always says that. So beyond that, if you're looking for more of my actual morning routines, no, I didn't give it to you all. I kind of gave it to you in a nutshell. I do break the fast with fruit. So I had that fruit in the beginning, and then, you know, later on, I waited about an hour and a half or so, kept doing my rituals, kept reading, and I'm gonna journal, and then I ate the toast, the bread, that not necessarily the best for you, but I was treating myself, and I've been experimenting with eating one piece of chocolate a day. So I'm on day two. Yesterday I only ate one piece. It's not a very big bar, but it's 100% cacao, and I just know the health benefits of eating chocolate every day. The big, you know, about it is like, can you eat just one? And yes, you can. I can, I will, and I must. So that's my next challenge for myself. I challenge you to challenge yourself every single day. How did you improve today? And how will you improve tomorrow? Set an intention, create your reality. Canelo Bobby, subscribe to this channel. I love you very much. Thank you for checking in with my morning routine. I'll try to give you more versatility on what I actually do. It is a very long process. It's like two and a half hours. But know that I started like 15 minutes a couple of years ago, and then it just kept growing and growing and growing. I love you. Subscribe.